So hello, my name is Chris Weber. I'm pleased to introduce Nicole Jordan. Nicole, thank you for being here. You're a partner at Grant Thornton. Maybe tell me a little bit about what you do at Grant Thornton.
Yes, Chris, thank you so much for connecting today and looking forward to our conversation. So I am the managing partner for the Central Region at Grant Thornton. And Grant Thornton is a public accounting firm, a global firm, really helping businesses prepare for the future, whether that is in leading advisory technologies and capabilities. Maybe that is in preparing for AI and machine learning and the digital transformation that we are all under today, or that might be with leading tax advice or audit and accounting advice. So the spirit of it is all about helping businesses prepare for and really thrive in the future.
That's terrific. So maybe you can tell me a little bit about just how your industry has changed in the past few years, and then certainly with some of the things that are happening in the world today around COVID, et cetera, what things have been accelerated in these times?
Absolutely, Chris. It's a great point, and we certainly are living through change as we speak. I think probably the biggest transformation is the digital transformation that the professional services industry has been advancing towards, and it really has been accelerated in the pandemic. So I would categorize it as a bit of the silver lining that I think the profession is experiencing. Really proud on the one hand, and I'm sorry it took this situation to have us accelerate, but really proud of the way the teams and the profession, so beyond Grant Thornton professionals, but certainly I can speak to our Grant Thornton professionals, the way that everyone really pivoted to a virtual environment overnight.
Yeah, it's always excellent to hear. I mean, one, thank you for that, and you know how customers are using the technology. The other thing we heard from a customer the other day, and I'm sure you see it as well, we see it internally, is a lot of our meetings, particularly the internal ones, are actually more inclusive than the face-to-face, because normally in face-to-face, you have one or two people engaging in dialogue, and we see a very active chat window in addition to the audio video. And so it feels like many more people are participating in the meetings. And so in some respects, we used to run a set of meetings where we all got face-to-face. We've collectively said we're more productive in a remote world and more people have a voice in those meetings.
Chris, I completely agree. And I'll give you a couple of examples. So we absolutely use the chat feature, and that way everyone kind of keeps the conversation going. Everyone's able to share ideas. We use the digital hand, but also very interestingly, we use the polling feature, and that has been very powerful. So when you're in a strategic planning meeting, it's important that you can take these strategic questions that you have for the group and be able to get everyone's thoughts, and everyone's interested in what each other is thinking. And so when we could quickly put these polls up and understand, okay, that's a quick pulse of what does this leadership team see as the most effective way to solve this particular challenge, we were able to get through a number of key strategic issues very quickly through the polling feature as well.
So Nicole, maybe we switch to the customer-facing side with your customers and clients. And I know you're doing things innovative around LinkedIn and Sales Insights. And so maybe you can talk a little bit about those innovative technologies and things you're doing with your customers and clients.
Absolutely, Chris. So just kind of taking us back to our three main areas of focus, and this is really how we've leveraged Microsoft and teamed with you to help us during this pandemic and help us help our clients. So we first were focused on taking care of our people and then also in being there for our clients. And here's what we meant by that. So when the pandemic began, it was critical that we could reach out to our clients, check in with them, not so much from a commercial standpoint, but really to reach out to care, to be there for them, to listen, to learn, and to offer help. And so we started that process. The first thing that we did is went to our central repository for all of our customer contacts. In our business, we don't regularly send messages to all of our customers. But this was a first. And we really relied very heavily on our Microsoft relationship and our CRM system with Dynamics 365, just our central repository for all of our customer contact information. So we started there. Our firm, through our leadership with many wonderful leaders during this time, were very prepared for the pandemic. And one example is Yvette Connor, that she and her big team developed a pandemic resiliency tool. And we offered that to our clients on a complimentary basis. And clients could basically fill out the tool, and it would provide a risk assessment dashboard for them around the key areas of their business and how they were comparing to their competitors, kind of peer benchmarking around talent or around risk or the regulatory environment. And so this was very helpful information for them. But in order to leverage that tool that was highly valuable for customers in this environment, we had to dig in deep to the relationships that we had. And to do that, we leveraged our CRM tool. So we were fully engaged in Dynamics 365, and then also with LinkedIn Sales Navigator. We have been on a journey for many years to expand relationships within our existing clients. So we run a key account management program within our firm, and we have noted over the years, Chris, it's really wonderful outcomes that those teams within Grant Thornton that have a higher number of connections within their given key account have higher business results. So they have higher sales. They have a greater depth of relationship and client loyalty. So we have seen by really digging into the technology platform with LinkedIn, and connections on LinkedIn is one metric for understanding how deep your relationship is within a client organization. But that's what we compared. How many connections does this team have versus what are their wins? What are their sales? What's the value they're bringing to that particular client? So we leverage heavily Dynamics 365. We leverage LinkedIn Sales Navigator. And then we, on the internal side, we use various technology platforms as a repository to bring it all together and bring it back to our partners and our client-facing teams around what is working, around target prioritization, and how to bring similar value across similar sectors and similar clients. So examples of what we use there, Power BI. We have everything.
One of my favorites. Yes.
Yes, indeed. We have, so all of our teams have access to the BI dashboards. We run our sales pipeline management through BI. So it's pulling it from Dynamics 365 and it's bringing it into the BI environment, because that's a bit easier for our teams to work through today. And that gets distributed. Actually, it's updated every night, and our teams have access to it every morning. So it's built into their routine to be able to access the pipeline and the wins and the losses, and helps them understand the winning areas so that we can double down on that and bring that value across other clients. So Power BI has been key. It's all within the Azure environment. Very important that we connect a number of different technologies into this Azure repository so that we can pull the different areas that are of interest to a particular part of the firm. And another area, so in using Power Apps, or we have through our relationship, Chris, and this has been really meaningful for us, we teamed with Microsoft around how could we have target prioritization around opportunities where we may have brought value to a bank on the East Coast in the regulatory environment, help them solve a regulatory challenge. And how could we maybe take the principles of that opportunity and help banks across the U.S. and let the team all the way in the West Coast know instantly about the opportunity and know about the ways that we were able to bring that value. So we're using technology to do that. And we started in a strategy session with the Microsoft team in explaining how we wanted to basically use technology to help us bring more value, to help us kind of cross-serve a client or serve across a particular industry sector. And through our relationship with Microsoft, we worked on to develop areas and a custom tool for us. So it was through a teaming relationship with Microsoft and Hitachi and Grant Thornton. And through all of us working together, we created a tool that helps us with target prioritization. And so that ties into and leads us into sales insights and the AI-enabled selling that we'll be able to do in the future. We haven't fully implemented sales insights, within Grant Thornton at this time, but we're working towards that, and we're working towards training everyone on the power, really, of using machine learning and artificial intelligence to help them focus on the areas where they will be able to win.
Yeah, it's inspiring, Nicole, hearing like all the things you're doing, both to digitally enable your internal communication, collaboration, your connection with customers, bringing that innovation. I assume that just didn't magically happen overnight. Like, what was the change management process?
You're right, Chris, and we're all human, and we don't always like change. And so I would say it really has been an effort where, number one, we've tried to unite around the improved business outcomes we can achieve by using the technology. And improved business outcomes are real. They're getting better results by using the technology. And here are the three improved results. Number one, they're able to connect with a broader number of clients and deepen relationships widely across an organization using technology. Number two, they're able to focus on opportunities where we have a higher likelihood of winning. We get many opportunities. And in some cases today, we've got to focus our time on those areas where we really can connect with the client and bring value that will resonate and work for their business and where we will win. And so we've got to prioritize those opportunities. We're using technology to be able to do just that. And then the technology is helping us with the speed and the accuracy of all that we're doing. So just a different example on this, Chris, that today, the number of opportunities that we have that have to be turned around within a couple of days. So a business will contact us and our client and would like us to turn around a proposal within a very short period of time. And they need that for various business reasons. And using technology is really the only way to do that. And it starts with fundamentals like OneDrive and being able to allow everyone to have access to editing the live document and bringing everybody's ideas into it, because we believe very strongly that the best way for us to bring value to clients is to have a diverse team thinking about their business problems. And using technology is a key way to building diversity and inclusion into the way that you work to solve a problem for a particular client. So we use technology, OneDrive, where everyone can access, or we're using Teams where we can have strategy sessions around a client. And with Teams today, I mean, how great is it that we're not only connected on video, but we can, through the power apps and the different functions within Teams, you can bring up that specific account and bring up all of the information related to an individual executive that you're serving, or maybe all of the different account team notes, all of the latest information going on with that company or that business. You pull it right up on the screen and everybody has access to it. And so just again, the technology improves our speed. It improves our accuracy with all that we're doing. It's helping us connect more broadly with clients, and it's helping us focus our time and our money, our resources on areas where we can really bring the greatest value to clients and where we can win as a firm.
Wow, thank you for sharing. And, you know, first of all, just thank you for the partnership. Thank you for pushing us. You make us better in terms of how you're implementing the technology, the things that address your business. So we really appreciate that. And more importantly, thanks for sharing today and inspiring all of us on how you're taking care of your employees, your customers, and business. Truly inspirational. And so, Nicole, can't thank you enough for that partnership and inspiring us today.
Thank you so much, Chris. It truly has been a pleasure, and I look forward to all that we have ahead of us in this journey as we move forward. So thank you, Chris.
Thank you.